No change. They've been in all games. That's Grant Fuhr. And don't let the average fool you. There have been a lot of goals in this series. He and Mario Lessard have come up with fantastic saves, even though, as we say, Fuhr has been beaten 17 times, and there was, of course, an empty net goal in the first game. And Lessard has been beaten 16 times. But, Don, you'll agree, they have been outstanding.
Well, they have. Even though the high scores have been high, Fuhr kept them in there for the first 10 minutes of the first period. He was sensational. Felt bad after that overtime, and was no fault of his alone. But getting back to the anthem again, you know what happened Saturday? Just happened. An Oiler happened to cut the cable for the anthem.
Well, we're underway in this big, big game for the Edmonton Oilers. The Los Angeles Kings going in, looking for first blood. It's cleared into the corner. Bozek on with Smith. And Hopkins can't come up with it. And Edmonton will clear it. And Curry losing it. Smith knocked away by Fuhr. First shot of the game, and it was a dangerous-looking one. Play called on the offside at the Edmonton blue line. So L.A., Don, have come out flying, and they're looking for the first one.
Well, this crowd gets them pumped up. This is their third sellout, I think, of the year. You get a big crowd in here. This is one of the noisiest crowds in the National Hockey League. They really go, and they don't get them much here. And they're pumped up. They're ready. They've got nothing to lose. L.A.'s got nothing to lose. They're supposed to be out of here now. That's the way they feel.
Complete sellout again tonight. And you have to go back 5-6 years to find where the L.A. Kings have sold out 2 Stanley Cup playoff games in a row.
Yes, I know the team.
I think you do. Win it?
Boston Bruins, and we won that series. I don't like to say that all the time, but you let me into it, Bob.
Not dressed tonight for Edmonton, Brett Callaghan and Matty Hagman say they're going with 7 defensemen dressed. LaRiviere did not play Saturday night. He's out there tonight. Sims, Therrien, and Sykes not dressed for L.A. Fuhr in back of the net to stop it. That's Kevin Lowe trying to clear it. Chartraw backs up as the Oilers move it down. Hughes going in for it. But Lessard out of the net cleared. It's got out, kept in, comes back to the line. Pokalin's low shot. Hughes tried to make contact and just missed it. Unger gets it back to the blue line. They keep it onside. A shot, it went in wide of the Los Angeles goal. Now Fogelin dumped it in along the boards. Fogelin again, still fighting for it. He cleared it in behind the net. Chartrand takes over for L.A. Rolled it up to the blue line at center. Here come the Kings. And a hard shot by Dion was wide. Under, a long pass to Hughes. Hughes on a solo dash decides to shoot it in, and the Oilers change as the play comes back out to center ice. Ralston couldn't stop his man. Greg flipped the backhander into the center ice area, and Larry Murphy shoots it in for L.A. It was a weak shot by Jean-Paul Kelly. No problem. The Oilers just dump it out to center ice. I think they're trying to slow the pace in the early going of this game. They can hang on. Their theory for 5 minutes or so, the crowd might settle down. They can get something going, but the Kings are fired up. Here they come. Kelly took a shot. That was blocked by Fuhr. After it is Bernie Nichols. He fell in the corner. Fox trying to dig it out. Again, Nichols. And he's bumping in there with LaRiviere. Here's a drive. No shot. Didn't miss by very much. Wells keeping it in, and he was bumped by Lumley. Kings with great pressure on now. They hold it on the boards, and the play is called. A faceoff coming up in the Edmonton zone.
This is an emotional series, Bob. Lumley just knocked Chartrand right over the boards, and they're going at it. They're talking right now. I tell you, there's been hitting, banging, scoring, goaltending. This has been a great series right from the word go.
It's been very chippy out there, Don. There has been more kibitzing and needling in this series than some of the officials have seen in a long, long time.
I have not seen a lot of stick work going on. We won't mention that. We hope it doesn't start. A lot of stick work.
Now the faceoff deep in the Edmonton zone. They were out of position, so they'll have to do it again.
Who do you think is in the driver's seat now? Forgetting about who's leading in the game.
L.A., they're not supposed to be here, Bob. They're loose as a goose. Pressure on the Oilers.
Whoa, look out. That was close. Dewar, always alert. Watch that one. Oh, man nearly put it in, and that's a sign of shakiness.
Well, you know, before the game, I was talking to some of the Oilers, and the Kings had something to say about Gretzky. I won't say what it was, and it really inflamed the Oilers. And Glenn Sather says that's all you need is one little thing. Silton gets it out. He knew what he was doing. Pure had that the whole way. Puts it up here. But all you need is one little thing like that to fire him up.
Gretzky is knocked down after he got the draw. Now Curry will try to back up with it. Huddy at the line, shoots to the center. Cleared in by Charlie Shimmer. Into the corner is Huddy, and he was bucked hard on the play. Curry starts out with it at center ice. Tell you, this is a rough series. Here comes Huddy, good shot! That was stopped by Lessard. Huddy wound up and really let her go with that low drive. Siltanen backs up to Huddy. Back to Siltanen. He lost it, managed to get it back though. A pretty good play by Siltanen. He had gone to the ice. Down to the center ice. This is Anderson coming in. Fake the shot. Curry goes in front of the net. Tried to tip it by Lessard, but Lessard grabbed it. A quick glove of his. Gretzky got it over in front. Chopped off the boards down the ice by Dave Lewis. No score. 3.5 minutes gone in the first period. Gretzky kept one in. Goes in looking for it. Chartrand, number 27, back for L.A. Far side, Hopkins couldn't get that pass. It's down the ice. And icing will be called with Kevin Lowe back. From the Forum in Los Angeles, this is Stanley Cup 82 on CBC. I'm Bob Cole with Don Cherry and John Wells at the Forum in Los Angeles. No score nearing the 4-minute mark in this first period. Players go to the boards right in front of the bench. And they freeze the puck, so another face-off in the center ice area.
Well, I can see what why Glenn Sather dressed 7 defensemen. What he's going to do, you saw Huddy up there taking the shots. He's going to let his defensemen go up, take the shots, and go, go, go. Lots of mobile there.
Told me today that possibly Paul Coffey could be moved up front. Later on, we'll see what happens in the game as it moves along as Hardy lays it off. Clear it in. Far side, that's Randy Brett. 21 lost it. Big chance for L.A. And Fjord made the save. Into the corner, Hopkins trying to dig it out. With Doug Smith and helping him, they hold it on the boards. Another giveaway there, Don, inside the blue line, and it nearly cost him.
Well, this is what happened. A little push and shove and nothing going on. This is exactly what Greg did is Saturday night. He threw the puck up to Simmer. He walked in and got the third goal. You cannot throw the puck away like that in your own end. You just can't. You're going to pick it off and walk in, and that's what started the Kings going the last time. He just can't go and throw them away. We got two penalties here. Ron Wicks is settling them down right off the bat.
Hopkins of L.A. is gone, and it's Randy Gregg of Edmonton. So the first penalties of the game.
That's a penalty to number 21, Randy Gregg. Los Angeles penalties to number 12, Dean Hopkins. 2 minutes each for roughing.
Roughing penalties at 4:15.
You cannot believe, Bob, and the people cannot believe that haven't watched this series, the ill feeling, and it's been going on all year, but this is one of the heated series that I've seen in a long time. I can't remember a series where there's been such a, I don't know what the word is, but boy, they're ready at a drop of a hat to go.
Bernie Nichols is number 9. Got the draw back, but Unger went after it. Prevented a shot on the net, maybe, from the blue line by Chartrand. Now, here's Unger to center. Up over the line he goes, shooting it in. Unger working hard for it. He spun around to the side of the net. The Kings try to clear it out. Mozek waited for the pass. It didn't come. Here's a penalty coming up against the Edmonton Oilers. The net is empty. They have the extra man on, but Fjord touches it. And now they call the play, and the penalty is coming up against Edmonton. Tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Los Angeles. Mark Messier, a hooking penalty here at 4:42.
Well, he pulls them down. This is a needless penalty. You don't need this at the start of the game like this. Now it's 4-on-3. Dion out there. He's got a lot of time to maneuver.
Dion with Taylor. Again, an This is a great opportunity now, Don, for the Kings to draw first blood.
Well, like I say, Dion out there, so important, the draws here. We got to get the draws here. Watch Taylor get in front.
There's Taylor in the slot, but the Oilers pick it up and clear it down the ice. A minute and 20 seconds left in the minor penalties against Gregg and Hopkins. L.A. starting to move it. Dion didn't get the pass. It was nowhere near him. And the Oilers shoot it back. Korab goes back. Taylor to the right. Lake comes this way to Dion. Taylor on the move in the right wing as Dion carries in. Dion is bumped, put off stride, and it's cleared by Hunter on the boards, but not out. The Kings keep it in. There's the goal. Dion in front of the net, and I believe got his stick on it.
Well, there's a classic case of throwing the puck away in your own end. All you young defensemen, watch Dion tip it in front. Pierre never had a chance. Change directions and in. Never give that puck away. Here's the shot again from the point. Watch Dion tip it in front. Never give that puck away. Pierre never had a chance of that when he changed the record. Never give that puck away when you're killing a penalty. Eat it, do anything. You're going to have to clean the ice there, Bob. They threw a bunch of paper on. It's going to take a while. But that's, never do that. That's cardinal sin, and you saw what happened. There it is. It goes around, and he takes a shot. All he tried to do was lay it up in front for something to happen because he never had time.
Evans, who's been a big scorer for the LA Kings in this series, got an assist also on the goal by Dion here at 5:27, and that, again, was a power play goal for LA. This is Hockey Night in Canada from the Forum in Los Angeles. So the penalty to Messier, a costly one for the Edmonton Oilers. While they were shorthanded, Dion skating in front of Fjord, tipped in the shot by Evans at 5:27 here in the first period. There's Dion. He's pretty happy about it all.
You don't want to get a 4-on-3 with Dion. He's a 50-60 goal scorer, too. And, you know, some fan come in here with all that paper ripped up for purposely throwing on the ice. You talk about low mentalities.
So the Oilers find themselves suddenly down a goal, and they cannot afford many more of those. It's been the Kings who have been coming back in this series. Let's see now if the Oilers can.
They're fired up, Bob.
That's Larry Murphy, number 5, back in his own zone for L.A. Passed it off to the left side, and Wells turns around with it. Lays it back. Murphy gets it out to Nichols. Nichols is stopped. Curry all the way back in the Edmonton zone. Now the Oilers move it. Center ice is low. Gretzky into the corner. He went off balance. Can he get back in time? He got it over in front of the net, but Jay Wells was there. He couldn't clear. Kept in by Lowe. His pass is stopped. And the Kings shoot it to center. Gretzky comes back in. Looks dangerous. Gretzky got it. It was cleared away by Murphy, who fell in front of the great superstar of the Edmonton Oilers. Back for Wells. A pass to Nichols. Make the shot. There it is. Knocked down. The rebound is steered against the side of the net. Wide open in this first period. 1-0 L.A. Nearing the 7-minute mark of the first period. Gregg at center. His penalty served. Gretzky going in again. Take the shot. Center into Curry. Good play. Curry didn't get a shot through. Huddy will try it. It's not going to rebound. Went by Gretzky. Through the crease and by him. He didn't see it. Back for L.A. That's Kelly going in. Kelly backhands it into the corner. Now Hardy tries to come up with it. He's in for checking. But it's Siltanen coming out. Gets away for one check. That was Kelly tried to stop him. He tipped it in over the line, going back to Swan. Left it behind his own net. Smith ran into his man. Siltanen from the blue line. His shot is blocked by Smith. Fox is coming out. Up the line to Hardy. Hardy with Chartrand on the far side. He couldn't handle the pass. Anderson dumped it in again. They played 7.5 minutes of the first period. 1-0, L.A. The goal by Dion. While the Kings had the man advantage. Win tonight, of course, for Los Angeles, and they will advance against Vancouver. Edmonton trying to fight back now. Greg was bumped. No place to go as Hardy taken out of the play. Here comes Kelly again. Kelly going in, dumped it to the corner. And the Oilers come back for it. They've reached the 8-minute mark of the opening period. Oilers change as the play goes on. And there was a trap there with an extra man on the ice. Olivier dumped it behind the net. Coming out, Rawlson. Taylor chasing him. Lovely gives it away, and Grant goes in with a shot. That's deflected on the boards to the right of Mario Lessard. Now Dave Taylor bringing it back out. Stopped near center. Trailing the play is Lewis. Lewis going in. Nice move by Lewis. But offside is called as Taylor brought it in on this end. With the score, Los Angeles 1, Edmonton nothing. This is Stanley Cup 82. Play just underway. 11:22 left in the period. 1-0 Los Angeles. Don, the Kings have come to play for sure tonight.
Well, what they're doing with Gretzky, too, when he's out there, they're finishing the check on him the way Boston did. Every time they come near him, no matter what happens, they give him a little shot all the time. But I want to tell you something. Gretzky scored a shorthanded goal Saturday night that give everybody in this building chills. It's got to be one of the greatest goals of the year. He walked around four guys. That made Dr. Jerry Buss get up and leave the building on that one.
I think it was 5-1 at the time when he left. He never did come back. Got a pleasant surprise, though, when he heard the final score in overtime, 6-5 for Los Angeles. That has to go down as one of the most unbelievable comebacks in Stanley Cup history. The man who got the overtime goal.
They say he's built like Man Mountain Dean, a little stocky guy. He's got arms on him. Man Mountain Dean.
Lewis is 25, and he shoots it in for L.A. That's Greg in behind the net. Dumped it out in front. Nearly lost it again. He did. You're coming up. The low shot went to the far side and just missed the corner. Now that Messier fires it down the ice. Too far for Ralston. Lewis back to the net for L.A. Play comes through the middle. Greg ahead to Messier. To Lovely. Lovely doing some pretty good work. Got a pass to Silk for Ruddle. Riviere took the shot, and that hit Dave Lewis, and Greg goes back. He's being watched by Mike Murphy. Behind the net, gets the pass up to the line. Kelly couldn't stop it. Oilers on the move. This is Messier. Up over the line he goes to Ralston. He grabbed it back. Going up on the play. It's slapped back to center ice. Four Kings. Four of them going in. Kelly didn't get the pass. It was intercepted. Back for Ralston of Edmonton. In with a shot. Deflected high into the crowd.
Well, Greg coughed up another one. He's got to stop that going up the middle. He almost cost him again for another goal. I don't understand it. There's Fuhr. Now, I'm going to let you in on something that not many people know. After the 10-8 game, he painted the mast over again, and now he's got three little marks on there. But he figures for luck, a little psych or something, they got himself psyched up.
10:06 remaining in this first period. 1-0 Los Angeles over the Edmonton Oilers.
There is Lessard. Now, Lessard, if you could get a... See how big his eyes are? He's cut those eyes out to start the playoffs. He shaved them down to get better visibility. Then the next time we have a thing on Fury, you'll see.
But he didn't quite get a good shot away. The puck rolling. And it gives L.A. a chance to move it out again. Cleared from center by Nichols. In line of the net. Into the corner. Oilers come up with it. Long pass to break for Curry. He's in a long run in. Good. Curry got that long lead pass by you-know-who. He spotted him somehow, and he was in behind everybody, and it's tied at one.
Well, Wells made the wrong mistake here. Here goes Curry, and he knows what he's doing. Gives him a little fake, pulls at the top corner, but the mistake was Wells standing up. Here it is again. A good angle here. Good shot. Gives a little to the backhand. Up high. But Wells stood up and tried to catch it with his hands. Now watch how he does it. Gretzky almost plays it that way. A little flip. See how Wells got it behind. He should have played the man, because if he had the man, it doesn't matter where the puck goes.
Pure, the goaltender, also got an assist on that tying goal. Next, Zimmer going in, centered it in front of the net. Taylor was covered and took a shot away. LA stay with it. That's Zimmer getting it out front. Dion digging it from the corner. Dion gets set. Get a Taylor. Dion! And Pure gets all the way. Went to the far side and stopped the angle on him. Shut him off completely. Dion had no place to go but right at the goaltender.
Pure stayed right with him all the way. Never went down, went across, nowhere to shoot a call.
That last scoring play, Curry from Gretzky and Grant Pure at 10-18. And we're tied at one.
You know, a lot of people say that Gretzky just fired the puck up there. If we could see that again somehow and see the little flip as it comes to him, he'd give it Wells a hard time to handle that puck, and he knew what he was doing when he made that pass.
You think they planned that before the puck was dropped in, because Don Gretzky went over in the corner and Curry just turned and left. He was 90 feet away.
That's what he did, and Wells made the mistake of not playing the man.
So Gretzky flipped it from deep in his own end, got it bouncing near center, went by everyone, and Curry was home free. And he made a good play on Rossard. We're tied at one. Dion scored first. Now the Oilers having more difficulties. They're laying on the body again inside that line. Cleared to center. Anderson didn't get the pass. There's Anderson moving on the left side. He's going in, knocked it in the direction of Lessard. He was out to clear it himself. Drake comes back. Laid it to Curry. He had it knocked away. It goes back in over the line. Drake turns again to Gretzky. Pass behind him on the other side for Anderson. Hopkins ran into him. Here comes Gretzky in front. It went to the goal line. Did not go in, apparently. Right to the line. The LA Kings come back. They look for a break now. After that close call, Gretzky tried to tip it in. In back of the net is Hopkins. Couldn't move it out. My goodness, Don, that was close to the goal line up there behind Lessard. He had a vision block. He couldn't see, but Gretzky, he thought he had it in.
Well, he got it on his backhand. He was on the line from up here. It didn't look like it went in, and I think he knew. Now watch, a good hit there. Now watch, he puts it. He hits the post. Comes back out, and it lays there. The Sarge got it played all the way, eh? And it's right on the line, I think.
It has to be completely over the line. We've got to see it again. It hit Lessard, rolled back. That's a tough angle.
See how they're finishing their check on Gretzky? No matter what he does, Korab will finish the check anywhere on the ice on Gretzky. Take him out of the play.
That was mighty, mighty close to a 2-1 lead. Here's a quick shot from the faceoff. That was blocked in front of Grant Pure. Unger ran into his check on the boards. Still fighting for it. They get another whistle and the faceoff again in the Edmonton zone.
Well, I noticed they've been taking a little extra run at Unger ever since that thing with Lewis. It's funny how guys remember that. They're not high-sticking them everything, but they're just giving them that little shot. There's Kevin Lowe. I would say one of the best defensemen in the National Hockey League. Never gets the recognition he should get.
He does in Edmonton, let me tell you. They voted him outstanding and their favorite defenseman this season. He's been a great standout on the defense for the Edmonton Oilers. And a good reason, one of the big reasons, the Oilers have come this far. Now L.A. on the draw. That's Zimmer getting in front. Dion tried to set him up. Long shot from the line. Didn't get very far as Murphy failed to hit it properly. Fogelin shoots it from center. Hughes tried to tap it in. Goes back at the net where Wells is after it. Wells lost it against Unger's in forechecking. Unger working hard on this shift again, trying to dig it out, but it's cleared down the ice by the Kings. 7:25 left of the period. Score is tied at one. Pass to center ice. Ralston had a go behind him. Slides into the corner, and back there is Kelly. Kelly for LA starting out. Right wing pass, nobody there. Oilers in position, shoot it back in. Fox is stopped, now it rolls over the line. Fox picks it up, gets in front, he plays. In for Nichols, he's around the net. Nichols stopped on the boards. Lumley going back to help out. That's Siltanen with it. Comes to Messier and Ralston. Messier is bumped, played it back into the corner in his own zone. They're down the ice again. Messier is given a jolt by Rick Chartrand. Hardy stepped away from one check. Kelly picked it up in front of the net for L.A., nearly lost it there. Lovely's keeping it in. Play a little scrappy over there at this point, and they get it down where Siltanen turns. To Messier. Messier is off past the center. Huddy coming in, and he was bucked by Chartrand. Chartrand going off balance after throwing that check. Now back down the ice for L.A. Evans trailing the play. It goes into Fox. He centered it. That's broken up. Messier handed away. Here's Fox again. In front of the net. Fox can't get a shot away. Turns on the board. Trying to slide it back to the net. He did. Bjor covered up again. And he holds on. Hockey Night in Canada will continue in a moment. Just getting ready for the face-off to the left of Grant Fuhr. 5:52 left in the period. 1-1 tie. Bob Cole with Don Cherry here in the broadcast booth at the Los Angeles Forum. They're down on the right side. Oilers trying to pick it up. Riviere has to back up in his own zone. He needs it for Greg to back first on the board. Taylor tried to keep it in, but the Oilers move. Gretzky's pass to Anderson didn't quite work. This one to Evans is good, though. Evans going in, screenshot deflected high into the crowd. What a tremendous comeback on Saturday night, Don. Going into the third period, L.A. down 5-0. Do you think they thought really they had a chance in the third period? What do you think Perry said to them in that intermission?
As Glenn said, chewing the gum. I know exactly what he said to them. Listen, guys, it's going to be pretty tough to win this game. Let's just have a good third period. We get a little momentum for Monday, and that's exactly what he said to them. All of a sudden, we got a few penalties. We got and then all of a sudden, they got a little life. They start to antagonize the bench going to them, and bing, 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 bing. They never really, honestly, I talked to them, never really expected to win that game.
Well, they've got great confidence now. They have an opportunity to advance in Stanley Cup play. They're here at home. They're tied now at one with 5:50 left in the first period. And they came out of playing tonight, believe me. Oilers, on the other hand, slow in starting in this one. It's dropped at center. Hoegelin shoots it in. Hughes going in to look for it. On the board, cleared by Cork. Well, rather, he can't get it out. Again at the far side, kept in by Lowe. Murphy finally hooked one high into the center ice area. Coming back, Lowe for Edmonton. Turning against Simmer. Long pass into the zone. It bounces in over that line. And icing is called against Edmonton. Live from the Forum, the Stanley Cup Playoffs. I'm Bob Cole with Don Cherry and John Wells at the Forum in Los Angeles. 4:43 remaining in the opening period. The score tied at one.
Don Perry, you know, he's not getting the credit he should. Keep those guys going when they're down 5-0. That's a sign of a good coach. You don't give up.
Smith got the faceoff back to Chartrand.
Left hand of Grant Fuhr again.
He's hot again, Bob. He's hot again. You know, this LA team has a really young team. People don't realize that. 11 of their 18 goals. Here's the shot now. Gretzky loses the faceoff. It's back. Look at Fuhr ready with that glove open like that. He's got it ready all the time. All you young left-hander, too.
So they'll do it all over again. This time Edmonton with a draw. And they get it out to center to Lumley. Lumley shoots it in. Chartrand the first one back. He gave it to Lumley. He centered it. Comes back to Lumley. Lumley bumped off the puck, but he pokes it into the corner to Messier. He lost it against Hardy. And Hardy coolly back to the zone net. Now to Bozek. He's starting down the left side to center. He has Smith with him. Smith with the pass, and he just flipped it into the corner. Kozak failed to come up with it. Smith went over in front of the net, but the Oilers clear it. Ralston, a long pass. Messier takes the shot. Now he's stuck over there. Gets it back to Honey. Long, hard shot. Deflected. Honey walked right into it. Here's another chance. Messier, the backhander, didn't work. And it'll be cleared by Korat. Out to center. Zilkin had stopped it there. Honey fired it back in, and Korab goes back. 3:35 left in the period. King's on the move now. This pass down the right side, and Smith cutting in. Drove a shot a little high and wide. Kelly put one into the corner. Again back there is Gregg tying up his man. The Oilers trying to move it out. Anderson. Couldn't get it by Nichols, but it comes to center anyway. 2-on-1, Gretzky going in with Curry. Gretzky lost it, but here's a chance. Anderson's shot is blocked. Three of them are in there on that play. Nichols right back for L.A. Tried to go in. And it's called on the offside. This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Los Angeles. .305 left in the period. 1-1 tie. Edmonton's Gretzky looks for Curry again. Played it on this side, and LaRiviere goes in, took a shot, deflected again high on the glass. Fox moved it out to center, Nichols chasing it, but Anderson, who's a speedster for Edmonton, got back. LaRiviere on the board, he's fine. Smart move, though, Don. He couldn't find a place to put it, and he held on to it.
Well, what we call that is eat the puck. Don't throw it blind up anywhere when you don't know where it's going as a defenseman. You can see Glenn Sather's plan. He's got those defenses. You see LaRiviere go up the side there. Huddy going up the side. Those defenses are going. But what you have to watch, you have to have a forward draft back and take his spot. If that doesn't happen, it's going to be a 2-on-1.
2 minutes and 40 seconds left in the first period. The L.A. Kings scoring first. Dion tipped one in from in front at 5:27. And Curry set up by Gretzky and Fuhrer on a breakaway, 10:18. Now we're set. Watch these face-offs. You heard it said so many times. It's so very important. Over there is Unger. He shoots it down the ice. This will be icing again. And Wells goes back. How do you line him up, Don, in the face-off deep in that zone to either side of Fuhrer?
Well, Unger has just been murdering them on the face-off. He takes them left-handed, right-handers. He's just killing them. That's why they missed him so much. But you got to get down there. A lot of intensity. And watch how close Unger gets down on the thing. And he's murdering everybody.
Simmers into the faceoff spot. Dion parked just behind him. There's the play back to the line. Unger gets a pass out to center ice. There's Hughes. Hughes breaking in. Took a backhand shot. Went by in front of Lassard. Into the corner. It's cleared along the boards. Fogelin waits for it. It nearly moved, but they hold it along the boards. John Wells with another one of our celebrities tonight, Red Buttons. John?
Okay, special guest in the audience, Red, how do you enjoy ice hockey? Are you a real fan?
Not enough excitement for me. I like ping pong, water polo.
Obviously a fan of the Los Angeles Kings. This town has gone mad over the
Kings. We've gone crazy, especially after the last game.
Were you here for the last one?
No, but I wish I were. Probably is going to go down as one of the all-time classics.
Thank you very much for taking time.
That's a great pleasure. Say hello to all my friends in Canada.
Thank you, Red. Thank you.
Okay, Red. Say hello to all your friends in Canada. You got it. Too bad you weren't here Saturday night. It would beat your ping pong game any day.
What's that ice hockey John's talking about?
2:10 left of the period. 1-1 the score, and Hardy is back. Stops behind the net, Sharpaw in front. Watching his man, Laurie Boschman, on for the first time in the game. Huddy flipped it on the boards, and Messier. To Lundley, in with Boschman. The pass for Boschman didn't work. It hit Bozek. That Bozek with it, coming out. Gets to center. Bozek picks the left side to clear it in. Fuhrer taps it behind the net. Siltanen back there. Huddy covering up in front. And the Oilers will clear it out. A minute and a half left of the period. His center is Siltanen. He's got that good shot. If he can get it away, ball on the outside. Thought he had stopped at the blue line, but apparently it just rolled over.
You see that Siltanen going. They've got them going. They've got something extra go the way Montreal does it. There's Sather standing on a bench. I asked him before the game, how does he get away with that with the crowd? He said a few things and straightened them out. Boy, Gretzky made a move on that two-on-one. He fooled everybody in the building. I didn't even see the guy coming. We're sitting up here. Somehow he saw him coming, Lumley coming late.
And Gretzky at center ice for Edmonton. Hardy takes it inside the line. Gretzky nearly broke in. He's upended, and a penalty will be coming up against Hardy. And folks, Hardy gave Gretzky a terrific cross check when Gretzky was on his knees.
Well, I don't know if you picked it up, but he certainly gave him a cross check when he was down.
Well, that's what I was saying. They've got the orders. Here it is again. He makes a terrific play. It hits the skate. He's on his way in. He's gone. I don't know whether you'll finish it off. He falls down there. No, it's out of the camera range. And they've got, well, maybe we get it here now. He's on his way here. He's got eyes in the back of his head now. If they keep the camera on him, he does give him a shot when he's down. Gives him a little shot. He should get an extra two for that. I don't care. Hit a guy when he's down. I don't go for that stuff. But they have got orders. You can see it. Finish your checks on Gretzky every time he touches the puck. And even when he doesn't have the puck, they give him a little shot.
Let me tell you something. Was telling me, Don, excuse me, the other day, 168 pounds. He's not tough to knock down. He's hard to catch, hard to line up, but not tough to knock down. You're going to draw penalties when you hit him and hook him.
Well, I don't go for that, hitting the guy when he's down.
Coming in, the Edmonton Oilers now. Anderson tried to drop it. Gretzky goes in front of the net. Along the boards, Anderson. And he lost it. It'll be cleared out to center by Bonner. Down the right side, Murphy. Mike Murphy goes.
One minute left
of the period. Siltanen now. Edmonton with a man advantage. The score tied at one. There's Gretzky with a pass at center. Good goal! Gretzky! Oh, the save! By the side. Oh, what a move, Gretzky!
You don't see them much anymore, Bob. What a move!
There's Greg to Curry. My is exciting. Wayne Gretzky putting a move on the Los Angeles defense. He had them all flat-footed. Curry going in now. Curry gets set. On the other side, it goes to Greg. Took a shot. It's stopped by Lessard. 25 seconds left. Gretzky again coming in front. Could get a shot, but Greg will. It'll be screened, too. And it's wide. Gretzky back to the goal. Greg is over there. Bonner couldn't get it by him. Greg keeping it in. Now he falls on it. The puck is loose along the boards with 7 seconds left. And it's cleared down the ice. Fuhrer stopping it. That will run out the clock. In this first period, the horn goes. And we're in for a night again, I believe, Don Cherry.
Well, they're playing a lot. There's not as chippy as it was Saturday night. A lot better hockey game tonight.
Dion at 5:27. Curry at 10:18. And so the score at the end of the first period, Edmonton 1, Los Angeles 1. For sure, there is one we know. Quebec at the Montreal Forum in Game 5. And the second period is underway. And it's Korab to start it. He's been strong on the defense for Los Angeles throughout this series. Big Jerry Korab. Gretzky from center. At the blue line, Gretzky waits for it. It's in back of the net. Korab has it. Gretzky couldn't hook it away from him, but it's knocked down into the corner. Gretzky behind the goal, and he was stopped. Long shot from the blue line. Into the corner goes Curry. Fired it back of the goal. Gretzky tied up by Korab. Now the LA penalty is over. Hardy back on. Oilers pressing. Anderson gets it back near the line. Flipped down the boards, into the corner again, behind the net. Curry waits for it, back near the line. Gretzky gave it to Siltanen. He shot, hit near the net, and Korab stopped it. The Kings shoot it down the ice. There will be no icing. They played just 1 minute into the second period. And Edmonton losing the puck to get up. Great play.
with Evans in on top of Fuhrer, and he outguessed him, reaching out with a stick. Oh, what a chance for Evans.
The Oilers bring it back in. That's Gretzky looking for it. Murphy back of the net. Put it high on the glass. Murphy again. Can't move it out. He does to Smith on the second attempt. Smith is going in. Look at shot. Blistering drive. And again, away high. Rattled it off the glass. Gretzky gets a pass to Anderson. Fogelin with him. Anderson going in. Lowe is also up on the play. There's Fogelin back in the net. The defenseman trying to clear it back to the line to Gretzky. Gretzky winds up, fakes the shot. Gretzky got away from Simmer, then lost it to Smith. Doug Smith comes back for L.A. Goes in over the line. Smith couldn't get in front of the net. Fogelin was back there. Anderson didn't clear the pass. Comes back in front. There's Anderson whipping it out to Ralston. And hit hard at center ice, due by Chartrand.
Chartrand's been running around. I'll tell you, he's using his strength now. Don Perry's taken about 20 pounds off Chartrand, and he's using it. I tell you, the last game, he made two checks of the season.
Don Steve Bozek was telling John Wells during that first intermission about how different the playoffs are than the regular season. Of course, he was alluding to how the Oilers finished 48 points ahead of L.A., but he said, playoffs, it's completely different.
Well, it's a new season. Well, it's a new season. Look at Roger Nielsen, how he's got them going. Yeah, back check all the time. By the way, they're having their helmets on in the interviews now.
Chartrand tipped it in. Goes down the ice. This will be icing. You're saying that they don't back check during the regular season.
Absolutely. Everybody's getting their bonuses. Let's have a good time. As soon as the playoffs, that's when they start playing for real. This is a big line. He's put this big line together out here. You know, a lot of people haven't said enough about Don Terry and the job he's done. He turned it around. They all love him. The guys all love him. They'll stand by him all the way. He got in a lot of trouble with that Mulvey thing, but he's come out of it with flying colors.
Charlie Simmer in to take the draw. Taylor and Dion, the other men. There's Dion. But he got the shot through Chartrand, flipped it in front of the net. Fogelin was there. He seems to be always parked in front of the net, clearing it. And the Oilers shoot it down the ice. Guard, who likes to move out once in a while, is way out on that play. Back to the line to Lowe, put the shot, and deflected off the leg and hit Dion, and then missed the net. And Lowe is back in time. Dion up for checking. Lowe turning in the corner. Dion all over him. Try to keep it in. They can't. Shot down the ice. Racing in after it is Hunter. Hunter is there first. So the play goes right on. Hunter went in looking for it. Down on the boards behind Mario Lessard, and it's called. From the Forum in Los Angeles, this is Stanley Cup 82 on CBC. I'm Bob Cole with Don Cherry. John Wells at the Forum in Los Angeles, scored tied at one, just past the 3-minute mark of the second period. Boschman, Messier, and Lumley on now for Edmonton as Nichols comes out for L.A., shoots it in. Jim Fox racing it after it. It's chopped away by Huddy. On the board, the L.A. Kings keep it in. Korab gets in front. Korab can't shoot it. Out to the line and stopped by Lewis. Big shot, and Fuhr covered up with a stick. And it's cleared into the center ice area. Lumley and Boschman look for it. But the Kings shoot it back down the ice. It's in back of the net. An icing called against Los Angeles. The first period, Don, the Kings were very, very strong. But it seems to me now as if the Oilers are starting to get some momentum.
Getting a little momentum. Those whistles still thin. Boschman and Lewis have got something going over in the corner there. Boschman's very aggressive tonight. This is the first game he's really in there. He's after everybody. He's after Korab. Lewis is taking him off now. What happened was Lewis gave him a little shot underneath the chin with a stick.
So Gretzky is back on with Curry and Anderson. Greg on the defense with Gary LaRiviere.
Something wrong with the door on Edmonton's gate. They can't get it open, and that you have to watch that. If you don't have that right, you can
could be in a lot of trouble. Could cost you too many men on the ice, so they're trying to fix that up down there.
Greg Therrien of the Los Angeles Kings dropped by to say hello during the first intermission. And he wants to be remembered to his friends back in Marmora, Ontario.
Well, listen, I have to tell you something. All the Kings came to me, the guys that come from Ontario, said, please, would you tell us hello to all the people in Ontario, because they don't get to see us too much, so they're all thrilled that the game is going in Ontario, I'll tell you.
Sharon Bonner sends along a note. Say hello to her family in Manitoba. Well, we're coast to coast tonight in Canada. This game, the fourth of the series between the Kings and the Oilers. The Kings, definite underdogs, and they're right into the thick of it now. There's Nichols trying to center it, leading the series 2-1. Would eliminate the Oilers for the victory tonight. Fox in the corner. He was bumped, not to the ice. At the line, Big Horvat chopped at it. Fox is behind the net. Olivier going after his man in the corner. It's on the boards, and Curry couldn't get it out. Stepped inside the line. Good forechecking by Los Angeles. Now Gregg's pass to center. Away behind Gretzky. Gretzky moving the other way. Olivier takes his time. Put it on the glass. Now the ice. There will be no icing. It was hit near center ice by one of the Kings. Now Los Angeles shoots it down the ice. No question about this one. They're both stalling for a bit of time. Icing call. Tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Los Angeles. Something, a lot of icing and clearing it.
Well, this is a very important game. It's ridiculous to say that, but that's what happens. They got a young lot of players out there. They don't want to take a chance, but it'll open up. I tell you, this game is like a time bomb. You should see it after the whistles and things like that. Everybody wants to break loose, but they're afraid.
Nearing the 6-minute mark of the second period, Kings won, Oilers won. Leon scored first.
Slats has taken Unger away from Dion because Dion's been beaten.
Curry got the tying goal for Edmonton. Unger on the board. Couldn't pick it up. And it rolls inside the Edmonton line. That's Lowe turning with it. Lowe's pass. His center grabbed by Hardy. Hardy ducked it ahead. Back in for Fogelin. Fogelin going to the corner. Hunter trailing. Hunter got in front. Here's a chance for Hunter. Took the shot. It was blocked. Back for Taylor. In the simmer. He didn't see it. Taylor is bumped over there. He took a swing at Hunter. Stick so high, a little pushing. Unger lost his stick. He broke it in fact. Oilers come in. And the shot is blocked by Lessard, who came sailing out to cut the angle. Unger was racing him behind. This is Hockey Night in Canada from the Forum in Los Angeles. Once again, Gretzky, Curry, and Anderson up front for Edmonton. And the faceoff deep in the L.A. zone. The score tied at 1 here in game 4. And they're on Gretzky again tonight here.
Well, we won't say what they're saying.
Korab laid it back at the net. Bozek trying to bring it out. Does. Gets as far as center with Hopkins. Bozek going out. Couldn't play it in front of the penalty coming up against the Edmonton Oilers. Good play by Bozek. He nearly went all the way and he was pulled down.
Tough penalty, Bob. This crowd called that penalty. Watch now. Here he comes in. I know, but there's been a lot of things. I know that it looks like it there, and it could be. A lot of things have been going on in a tight like this. You have to be very, very sure. Nobody knows who got the penalty. They haven't gone off yet. There it is again. It was just like a little touch. Guy made a nice smile. He's going down. He should never. But the thing is, you should never put yourself in that position to get a penalty like that. That's the thing, to play it smart. There's a guy waiting there for him all the time.
There goes Anderson. The penalty comes at 6:32 of the second period. And the Kings now a man up on the power play. Gretzky racing to center, looking for that lead pass. It didn't arrive. Horab Curry. Gretzky Curry, penalty killers. That goes low. On the boards, Curry. Gretzky moving down. Couldn't reach it again. And the Kings are back. That's Evans slapping it over here on this right side. Fox coming out. Gretzky forced it back. Fox turning again to center. Moved in around Curry. Fox going all the way. And had it slapped away by Curry. Fogelin tried to move it out. Curry has it. Down with Fogelin and Gretzky. Gretzky going in. Decides to rag it back out. L.A. nearly took it off. Fox has it anyway. His shot is blocked. Fox got the rebound. A pass to Nichols. Nichols going in. And Pure came up big. Here's Fox. Gretzky couldn't move it out. Great pressure now by L.A. Nichols. And he lost it. Curry caught it. Fogelin ran into him. In the corner. Zimmer gets in front of the net. Taylor couldn't reach him with a pass. Now Taylor going after it. And they got a whistle. As Curry fell on it.
Oh, there you are. And
it's,
now what is that? That's not a two-minute miter. I don't know what is. Come on. I tell you, Steve, great action. Good power play. Fogelin is a little pushing and shoving. A little push and shove it in the corner, but you're seeing a good power play, how to kill penalties. They're going after a shorthanded goal when Gretzky's out there. They're going all the way. They're not trying to kill it.
They're offensive. All the while, this penalty is being served by Anderson. Gretzky is skating, roaming around outside the blue line.
Well, you see a little shot here. Say there, I mean, as Gretzky starts walking in, you'll see if you can hold it long enough, you'll see them give him a shot. Here he comes, and he gives him a shot, knocking down. I tell you, they're giving it to him when he doesn't even have the puck now.
They're nearing the eight-minute mark of the second period. A tightly contested contest here in the Forum in Los Angeles. Score tied at one. 43 seconds left in Anderson's penalty. Hardy snapped it on the board. Man advantage, Taylor's shot. Way wide, Dion set him up. Now Hughes shoots it down the ice.
Lowe and Fogelin have killed the whole penalty. Here they go off now, just as the puck comes out.
And now only 23 seconds left in Anderson's penalty. Turning around the net is Larry Murphy. Played to the left side and Simmer is forced back. Taylor and Dion go the other way. It's Taylor cutting in. Taylor over the line, stop, got it hooked away, but Dion has it. Dion is dangerous, and Gretzky, rebound is knocked down to the blue line, kept in. Hardy slapped it off the board, Dion again. Here's Dion, lost control of it, penalty is over, Anderson is back on. Dion falls, and the Oilers clear it out. Anderson out of the penalty box, and he goes to center with it. Anderson away from center, he's upended, and Simmer will get the cross-checking penalty. With a score, Edmonton 1, Los Angeles 1, this is Stanley Cup 82. Charlie Simmer put the cross check on Anderson and he's gone.
All right, here he comes down. Charlie's kind of playing defense. He's backing up. That's not a spot. He gives him a little shot. You could have called that a million things. High stick it, anything you want.
Coffey is on for his very first shift in the game, and there he is. Ahead to Anderson. Gretzky can't catch up to it. Wells fires it down the ice. A minute 45 left in the penalty now, and Edmonton lining up on this power play. Here they come. To the line. Not very far. Bonner broke it up and fired it back in.
L.A. goes after them, after them. They don't sit back. They go in there and force them all the time. They don't feel off.
This is Messier coming out. Messier to center. Backhands it in. That'll be back on the ice. Sharp ball was there.
In goal, Bob. They go right in. They go right out.
Bonner up into the goaltender, Grant Fuhr, as he came out to try and clear it. Coffey to center. Coffey picks the right side. Goes in with a shot. The rebound to Messier. He couldn't get a shot away. Anderson going back there. There's Messier and Anderson. And Korak fired it off the boards. Down the ice.
Well, I've seen Korak play for a long time. This is the best Korak's ever played in his whole career.
He's been great throughout the series, Doc. The Kings doing a great job. Smith going in with Nichols. Oh, I'll tell you. Grant Fuhr moving to his left. Shut off that right hand, and he saved a goal.
Well, if you didn't see the games, you'd wonder how you could say the goaltender played a great game. Now watch him. He's got that glove ready. You young goaltenders, if you don't have that glove ready, if you've got it down by your side, you're never going to make a save. You'd wonder how a goaltender could place. There's another angle of it. But he was red hot. He kept them in the game.
And the penalty, 44 seconds remaining, 9:58 in the period. The score tied at one. So the faceoff to the right of Grant Fuhr. We're in a tight hockey game. LA Kings leading the series 2-1. Gonna wrap it up with a victory tonight. Game five, if there is one, scheduled for tomorrow night in Edmonton. Coming in is Lumley. Lumley's pass over there, comes back to Coffey, hopped over to Stick, Gretzky. Hit near the net by Curry, that was close. Gretzky has it. Now Gretzky will maneuver it around, he lost it, it's stopped to the line, but not out. Kept in, another deflected shot just wide. Korak stopped by Lumley. There's Gretzky in front, it goes. And Curry is tied up by Smith, and the Kings shoot it down the ice again.
They can feed, instead of trying to feed that guy in front, they can feed those points, they're wide open.
Now the Oilers on the move, and it's Coffey getting away into Gretzky. The penalty is now over, and the Kings at full strength again. Gretzky out front to Lumley. Hurt shot wide. Knocked down in front. Rebound. And a break for Simmer. He's going down. Smith is trailing. Simmer closing in to Smith. Grant Fuhr again. Covered on the angle. And he made the save brilliantly.
Red hot, he followed all the way, Bob.
Hockey Night in Canada will continue in a moment. One-one ties, they drop it in. The Kings have the ball, they get in front with it. Zimmer goes back to the net. And they hold it on the board. This is Bob Cole with Don Cherry and John Wells at the Forum in Los Angeles, and what a tight one we've got going tonight.
I'll tell you, there's Gary Unger, and I keep saying about these older guys playing well, like Korab, but I have never seen, and I've seen him, I've known him since he's been 19 years old. This is as aggressive, the best he's played, checking-wise, since he's been in the league.
Score tied at one. And 8:46 left in the second period. The draw comes back to the blue line. Hurt, he slapped it on the boards. Into the corner goes Simmer. He was bumped there, and a penalty coming up. They're both going off, I think. Simmer of Los Angeles and Hunter of the Oilers. Live from the Forum, the Stanley Cup playoffs. The penalties. Simmer of L.A., here comes now Don and Hunter.
Well, it's a high stick and a little shot there. Ron Wicks is calling the right amount of penalties. He's keeping the game under control. This could really break open this game. There's a lot of bitterness here.
Roughing for Hunter, high sticking for Simmer. 11:22. Vogelin down to center ice. Shoots a long one in. That's Boschman going in, bumping there with Hardy. Boschman has it. In front of Cup. A drive from just in front as Boschman set it up, and Pat Hughes drilled it right through.
Well, Pat Hughes let her go. Zinger right between Lessard's legs. You'll see it. But Boschman was the guy that took shot draw, knocked his helmet off, went in. Watch this one. A slap shot right between the legs. But Boschman was the one that set it up. He went in. He hit shot draw so hard, he knocked his helmet off. Boschman was the digger.
Two diggers, Hughes and Boschman, got that goal. Hard work paid off.
The time of the goal, 11:40, and that's a mighty big goal for the Edmonton Oilers. They're leading now for the first time in the game, 2-1.
It's a big goal, I'll tell you. They're all big goals, but Boschman did the spade work on that one. Really hammered Shotrock.
Now Larry Murphy for L.A. Nichols is on with Smith and Jay Wells. That's Wells behind the net for Murphy. Murphy was bumped on the boards. Now the Oilers are doing the forechecking and carrying the game to the Kings. In on the boards, it's grabbed by Nichols down to the line at center. And Smith on the left. Nichols going in. He's been sharp throughout the series. Nichols stops. A nice play to the far side to Wells. Wells slapped at it. Rebound was there, but so was Huddy. Couldn't clear it out, though. Wells again on the board. Sharp angle, can't shoot it. And Charlie Huddy around the net. Decides to lug it out. Hitting the line to center. Got away from Smith neatly. And then threw a long one in. Gretzky is back on for Edmonton. Murphy spins away from Gretzky. Gets a pass up to Smith. Going in the shot. Rebound. Picked right back in front by Fuhrer. Nichols into the corner after it along with Smith, who has it. Smith. And he had it stolen. Gretzky back there. Nichols forechecking. And the Oilers move it out. 2-1 Edmonton now. Down goes Stilton in. Can't go through. The start out of the net again.
Well, now I think Saylor, what he's done. Now there's Saylor and Billy Harris. What he's talked to Greg, you see what happened with Greg there. He looked up, he didn't see anybody. So what, he took it in the corner and then they worked it out. Say there are Billy Harris, somebody has talked to him, or Teddy Green. Quit coughing that puck up. That's a Professor Higgins Mass, Lassard's got on from Boston Mass, a guy that makes him special.
Gretzky, 99, into the faceoff spot. Korab has something to say to Dion. Try to get the draw back to the big defenseman. He goes the other way with it. Dion coming out. Dion to center. Dion on the move now. Look at Dion go. And he flipped one. An easy shot away up high on the glass. Ozek keeping it in. In the corner, he falls. Gretzky comes up with it. Play in front of the net. And the Oilers get going. Curry, a pass down to the right side. Spinning around with Olivier, and he fell. Korab stops. Lost it in front of the net, now brings it out himself. Away from Gretzky. Korab lugging it in, firing the shot, and again deflected into the crowd.
Great. Almost as good as Beebop.
6:25 left of the period. Edmonton moving to center. Got it in, but then Murphy cleared it back out. Mike Murphy on with Bonner. And Kelly back in for Edmonton. Messier is offside. Strider two up the line. It's called.
There's something you very rarely see with Edmonton. They've got that crisscross flow and motion thing going offside. They very rarely go offside unless somebody pushed them. Look how he's playing Boschman more and more now. He didn't dress for a while. Now he's out there all the time. He is playing tremendous. Aggressive, aggressive. That's the way you got to play these playoffs.
Edmonton 2 and Los Angeles 1. 6:12 left of the second period. The fans here at the Forum. 16,005. That's a sellout here at Los Angeles. Chanting, trying to get the team going. The Oilers, though, have it turned on here in the second period. And they picked up the go-ahead goal. But Bonner now leads a three-man attack for L.A. Coming in with Murphy to the right. And they're offside at the Edmonton blue line. This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Los Angeles. Bob Cole and Don Cherry here in the broadcast booth. Forum in Los Angeles, it's 2-1 Edmonton. And Don, the Kings are starting to move it a little bit more now, but Edmonton so far has owned this period.
Absolutely.
Huddy goes to the left side as Siltanen brings it out to center, and he shoots it in. That's Messier allowing it to come back to Huddy. Huddy lost it. He fanned on it. Chartrand scooped it off the boards down the ice. And Evans failed to pick it up. Hardy inside his own line. up across center. They couldn't play it. Siltanen waits. Now to Messier. Messier shoots it in. It bounces down in front of the net. Cleared off the board, but not out. Boschman went in looking for it, and it's over the boards into the crowd again, right in front of us, and it's called.
The longer this game goes 2-1, one is better off for Edmonton all the time when you're playing on the road. And don't forget, you always got Gretzky hanging around there. He's going to pop one in. He goes back out again. Sorry about it.
Why do you say that?
Well, when you're on the road, it's better to go long and long and long. And the lower you keep the score, the more you keep even, it's all right. At home, you try to pump it up.
There's Greg. To Curry. His shot. Bumps it back. He's gone. Anderson got the goal. It trickled down in front and done. Nobody saw Anderson come in. And Lessard didn't have a chance. And Edmonton now lead 3-1.
Little break play there. What happened? They got a good break. He went to clear it, hit a defenseman and go. Now watch it. It had hit a defenseman, kicks it with his skate, puts it in the top corner. It was a break play. They didn't really have that set up or anything. And how it comes right across to him.
Edmonton
got a good break there.
So 3-1 Edmonton. Another drive, and that's just wide. Now the pressure is on L.A. The Oilers, Curry, fanned on it. They win it, though. Finally, the Kings bring it out. And it's blocked going to center. It was Nichols. On the other side, Kelly. And his low shot was just off the net. On the line, Murphy let it go. It'll be cleared by Curry. Gretzky waits for it. It goes to center. In goes Anderson with Gretzky, and they're offside at the L.A. line. That scoring play again. Anderson from Curry and Gretzky at 14, or rather Greg at 14:44. 3-1.
Game of bricks, Bob. That's what happened. He just fired it out, hit one of the LA defensemen, bounced right to him in the net.
What did the man say? You make your own breaks, you forecheck. Make them pop it up, as you say, and get them into a mistake situation. That's what happened. Up right in front of Lessard, and there was Anderson. Now the King coming out. Smith, left wing pass, under the skate of Bozek. Took the shot, gets it back again. Pogolin is in there along with Lumley. They hold it. Bozek got his skate down, and he held it. 4:11 left of the period.
Well, what's got to happen is Edmonton's got to keep going at him, going at him. He got a 3-1 lead. Don't sit back like they've done before. Go at him, get that fourth one. Have the one guy back. That's all right to have the one guy back, but don't have the whole five back.
Well, a lead hasn't proved to be too much for the Edmonton Oilers in a couple of these games. In the playoffs, they had a 3-goal lead in game one, 5-goal lead Saturday night. We all know what happened there. Kings came back tonight.
3-1 is peanuts.
Smith into the faceoff spot for the L.A. Kings, and he's against Boschman. Should never give up a 5-goal lead, Doc. Said and done, of course, but the Kings pulled it out on Saturday night. So, don't ever lose this game, no matter what the score. 3-1 now. Edmonton on top with less than 4 minutes to go in the second period. That's Bozek coming in. Shoots it in wide of the net. Justin takes it off the board. He fell. Cleared back in the corner by Korak. Now the Kings have it going again. They get it in front of Fuhr. And he waits there. The defenseman fell on it. Pretty close to the crease.
Well, what he did was he didn't really fall on it. He went down and just held it away. If he had gone down on it, it could have been a penalty shot. But he went to go down on it, and he remembered, hey, no penalty shots with 3 minutes to go. George McGuire, he doesn't look as happy as the last time I saw him.
3:40 remaining in the second period.
Does that tell it all right there? You want to be a general manager.
Dion scored first at 5:27 of the opening period, a power play, then Curry at 10:18. And Hughes at 11:40, giving Evans the lead. Anderson made it 3-1 at 14:44. They didn't do that fairly, and they'll line up to do it again. Unger has been one of the standouts from a forechecking point of view for the Edmonton Oilers, and he's been very, very aggressive. The strong man, Gary Unger, got the draw. You said earlier, Don, he's been doing that throughout the series.
And he stays with the gun.
Tip to center. Hunter waited for it. It didn't come. There's Unger looking for it. Rolls back inside the Edmonton line. Hunter takes it from Unger and goes in. Hunter nearly got through. Here comes Unger, and he can't find it. It's cleared out. It's by Hardy, and Dion is in. Dion swings to the far side. He falls. Back to the blue line to Hardy. Shot. Low shot wide. Chartrand will get a chance. There's a deflected shot in wide of the net. Taylor going in there with Dion. Simmer in front of the net. Dion trying to get away from Fogel and can't do it. And the Oilers clear it out. Low to center. Picking his way through. Now we get a penalty. Hunter, I believe, gets the interference penalty. That comes with 2:51 left, and that is not a good time nor a good place to take a penalty.
Well, you know, it's easy to say it done. What happened? He was going by him, and as you see, just touched him and he goes down. But again, you don't get yourself in the position to get a penalty. Now, I don't know. I like Ron Wicks. He's a good friend of mine, but I'll have to go along. That's a pretty cheap one.
Interference call against Hunter, and it gives the LA Kings the man advantage. This penalty coming at 17:09. Oh my, let's see what happens.
What's Glenn's doing here? He's stalling a little, he's having the guys go over, take tape off their stick, he's changing lines, just to slow things down a little. Don't throw your lines out there, let's get going. You notice the guy giving the guy the tape, and then they'll stroll around. Now Foglin's going over to give him tape, so you know, they'll talk to him a little while. So you stall a little bit, slow things down, get him a little rest, get Foglin a little rest, get Low a little rest. Just take it easy. Don't just be so anxious to get in there.
All right, they're set now as Curry plays it back to the line. Lobbed it up across center. And Evans is in there. To Korab. Korab lugging it up to center again. Shoots it in. Buehr stopped it behind the net. It's hammered by Curry. Shot with the lob by Evans. Put the shot. Not by Buehr. Evans again waits for it near the point. Here it comes to him. Evans flipped it on the board. Fox missed it. Now Curry a chance to clear, but Evans blocked it again. Get back to the net to Fox. Fox gets it back. Korab shooting. That's got the rebound. Right in front. Knocked down again. Fox in the slot. Waits for Hardy. Gets it back to the line. Goes into Bozak. Bozak waits again to Evans. To Bozak. Bozak closing in. Way wide of the net. Korab up to the line it comes. With 1:05 left of the penalty to Hunter. 1:55 in the period. 3-1 Edmonton. Here come the Kings. Evans! Look out! Rebound! That's lobbed away from Bozak. Bozak has it again. Bozak in back of the net. Paul gets back up again. Fogelin after it. They can't get that puck under stick to the Edmonton Oilers until Gretzky grabs it. And he comes slowly to center. Now watch Gretzky going in. Shooting! And that's off the glove of the side, and then off the glass, and he grabbed it.
Well, when they're out there, everybody says play the box. When Gretzky's out there, he'll give the left point the shot on the penalty. He doesn't play the box. It's more or less it's a triangle. He'll give the left point the shot, and then he'll go out. He'll never let the guy, when he's killing a penalty in the slot, get the puck.
That's Don Cherry with me, Bob Cole, in the broadcast booth at the Forum in Los Angeles. With 1:26 left in the period and 35 seconds left in an Edmonton penalty to Dave Hunter, it's 3-1 Oilers. And no doubt, Don, the Oilers just want to hang on now until this period is over.
Get it over. No goal here in the last minute.
That's Larry Murphy behind the net. Coming out slowly. Dion circles back with him. Now there goes Dion to center. Dion up over the line, gets ready for Taylor. Taylor's just ahead of him, didn't see the pass. He's back to the net. Simmer, and he was puck. Neon going in to help. But it'll be cleared by the Oilers down the ice with a minute left in the period. Hunter gets ready to step back on. He has 5 seconds left in his penalty. So he'll be on now before the Kings move it by center. Here's Simmer. The penalty is over. Simmer, stop. Huddy lost it. Neon. David Taylor. Taylor in front of Neon. He's upended. And it's Hunter again, bumped by Taylor. Coming out, the Edmonton Oilers. On a break down the far side. Goes Hughes. And get a shot. Lessard near the crease. They both went flying. 25 seconds left in the period with Simmer coming in. Simmer, a neat pass to Taylor. Taylor was bumped hard and knocked to the ice. And the Oilers, with 15 seconds left in the period, come in. Maybe get another chance for a goal. Into the corner. Cleared back to the net. And the Kings pick it up with 5 seconds left. They'll kill the clock as they clear it out to the center ice area. There's the horn. And the second period is over. But the Edmonton Oilers come out in this second period after watching the Kings, as I think, Don, kind of brought the game to the Oilers in the first, but Edmonton back and took charge in that second.
Well, they were ready, and the big play was Boschman hitting shot draw and knocking him off the puck, passing to Hughes. That was the big goal.
So the goals by Hughes and Anderson, and the score at the end of the second period is Edmonton 3 and Los Angeles 1. Joining us here in the booth for the third period is Brett Callaghan, a winger with the Edmonton Oilers, as the Oilers go in right from the opening faceoff, and Lessard has to be careful. He finally gathers it in as Bozek hooked it into him, and he held on to it. Brett, let me ask you, do you see anything different in this game than you had seen in the first two games up at Edmonton and the first one here?
Definitely more discipline on our part. Last night and our first game seemed to lose that discipline and sitting back and waiting and taking penalties and need those penalties. And that's what hurt us last game. So I think basically we're being a little more conscientious and more disciplined, and we're just playing an all-around better game.
Okay, Brett. Don Cherry now joining us again in the broadcast booth here at the Forum in Los Angeles. Korab shoots it behind the net. On the boards, the Kings trying to clear it. It's obvious. The Oilers are in forechecking. That's their slam with two in deep. Anderson got it in front. Gretzky was covered. The Kings trying to clear it out, and they're having all kinds of problems. It's centered again by Anderson, but nothing worked that time. Now Gretzky intercepts. Takes his shot. He put it right on, and Lessard hangs on to it. Don, the Oilers are here for real in the first minute of this third period.
Well, you can see that Sathers told him, don't lay back, get in there. Go all the way, go out in your shield. Good shot here. He's putting it on. He's not trying to hang on to the puck and get caught. They're going to have one guy back.
I think Glenn told him that, go out in front.
Yeah, he did. We said we have to go at him instead of sitting back and trying to concede the victory. And when you have a tendency to go in a shell, sometimes it backfires. So we have to go out at them and go at them hard.
Boschman's playing great, isn't he?
Yeah, he's an intensive player and takes the body well and instigator.
Chartrand got it ahead to Fox. Fox coming out with L.A. to center ice. Kelly on the left wing. And it's cleared in. Cruising around is Nichols in front of the goal. Oilers trying to move it out. On the board, Kelly into the corner. Again, Nichols goes into the slot. Here's Hardy. Took a shot that was blocked at the defense. And the puck bounced to center ice. Boston blocked that drive. Messier nearly stole it from Hardy. Coming back is Kelly for L.A. Long pass done by Lovely. And the Oilers standing up there, checking their wingers. Picking it off and clearing it back in was Lovely. It's 3-1, Edmonton. Minute and a half gone in the third period. Remember now, this L.A. team, a history of comebacks in this series so far. They were trailing 4-1 at one point in the first game and won it 5-0 going into the third period Saturday night and won it. Unger's neat pass went in through. A penalty coming up against L.A.
Good ice in here, Bob. Good ice in here.
From the Forum in Los Angeles, this is Stanley Cup 82 on CBC. Well, Simmer gets a penalty here, this is going to help Edmonton.
Absolutely. I think Simmer's going for the penalty crate. Pulls them down, no question about that one.
And the faceoff is deep in the LA zone. On the board, the Oilers, Curry turning around, Anderson in front. Curry from the side. He's waiting now till somebody has sprung open, and it's Gretzky behind the goal. Gretzky comes in front, and Lazare hangs onto it.
There's Fogel and tell him, get away, stop that stuff. Don't get carried away. Don't get off your game plan. I can tell when Glenn Sainer's not too interested in scoring. He's got Lowe and Foglin on the points.
Right, Brett? He doesn't have an extra guy out there or anything. He's got two solid defenses.
No, he just wants to play our basic strategy in defensive and not take any opportunity that's going to be against us. So just playing smart.
Right after that 5-0 washout, leading, going into the third period and losing, say there must have had some interesting meeting with you people right after that.
Yes, he did. I'll tell you about it in a minute.
Okay. We'll get some secrets from you. Fogelin on the board. Anderson back of the net for Gretzky. Couldn't pick it up. This could be dangerous. Bonner took the shot from a long distance. And Fjord, out to cut the angle, no problem. And a 28 left of the penalty to Charlie Simmer. Here come the Oilers again. Dropping it back. They'll twist and turn until they get the flow going their own way. But this time it doesn't work. Bonner again. Bonner nearly got in front. He was upended. Now Edmonton will clear it. Gretzky has to circle back, though. Picks up some speed. Stops. Goes again. Nearly lost it. Got a pass away, though. And it's low to center. And it goes to Curry. Curry up the blue line. Waits for a bit. Still holds it. Into the corner it goes. Gretzky trying to set up Anderson. Anderson waits. Gretzky has it. Gretzky in front of the net. Gretzky again with a slap at it. Gretzky in the corner trying to dig it out. They hold it. And now 33 seconds left in the penalty. Brett, you were starting to say, what happened in that meeting?
Well, I think, first of all, we realized ourselves as players that we made a lot of drastic mistakes that hurt us. And we had to collect our thoughts and get our heads up and think collectively as a team and not go into the next game with our heads down expecting, hey, we're afraid to make mistakes. So, and Glenn was very upset himself, you could see it. And he didn't have to say much. It was on his face, and I think it was on generally everyone's face. So I think together as a team, as a coaching staff, we knew what we had to do, and I think we're doing it tonight.
Don, obviously, the coach got through to them.
Well, what happens is it shows you what kind of heart they had. It would have been easy to die after losing after a 5-0 lead.
Well, it's 3-1 here. Here's a shot. Lazare out to make the save. And the Oilers keep the heat on. Greg slides it in front. Lazare stopped it again. Lazare brilliant now on this power play. 30 seconds left in the L.A. penalty. I'll tell you, if the Kings can hang on and kill this penalty, went for a whale of a finish. Icing now is called, and Curran with his stick up. And you can see, Don, the Oilers are just skating away. They will not be intimidated.
Well, like the time, the last time, if that had been the last game. Now watch him tick. Really goes in and really gets nailed. He's in the corner. Nice shot. What a save. He's there. He's got it. A little shot to the head. Nobody wants to take dumb penalties now. But they're disciplined now. Here's a heck of a shot here. Look at that. He's got it. A little shot. He gets in the face, too. But nobody wants to take it, like I said, a dumb penalty. Everybody... Cost you the series. We're getting a lot of shots on this one. Watch the stick come down. That Boschman, he's really something. Talk about aggressive.
I want to say right here, Don, what a fabulous job these technicians here in Los Angeles have done for us with their camera work and the replays. They've been just super, super people.
Well, there goes Korab off, and I think what happened was when Boschman nailed him behind the net, he twisted his leg, and that's what happened. And Korab, what happened was Korab never expected him to hit him because it was an icing, but all's fair in love and war, I guess.
The big guy in obvious pain.
Korab, he's been playing a good series, Bob, good series.
Ready for the face-off to the left of Fjord. They're waved out. 16:35 left in regulation time. I have to keep saying regulation time. We've had two overtimes already in this series. This is only the fourth game. 3-1 the score, Edmonton leading. On the move with 10 seconds left, with Zimmer's penalty, and the Kings have done a pretty good job killing it off. Zimmer gets ready to step back on. Penalty is now over. And along the boards, they hold it. We've got John Wells now. This time, a little chat with Jimmy Connors.
Jimmy, a pleasure to welcome you to our telecast back to Canada.
Thank you very much.
How do you like this game? What do you see in it?
Man, this is unbelievable. The excitement and the great hockey that's being played here tonight. You can't beat this.
Are you a fan who comes a lot to the Kings games, or is this really your hometown?
Well, no. I lived here for 11 years, but I live in Miami now. No hockey down there. But I was from St. Louis and saw a lot of the Blues play, and now here in Los Angeles, so I come as much as I can.
When you get the chance. Thank you, Jimmy.
Appreciate that.
Okay, John. The Oilers play it in.
Yeah.
And out it comes. Connors can hang on. We might get a chip or two on that game of his. Great.
I don't play with games that they love.
Here's Hardy. Played up to center ice. Knocked down near the line. Fogelin chopped away at it. Coming in, Zimmer. Circles in his own zone. Hardy now trying to get it going. Unger was upended inside the blue line. Comes to Taylor. Zimmer is with him. Zimmer going in, and Dion going in front of the net. But Unger is back there. He'll clear it. And it goes over the glass into the crowd, and she's starting to heat up down there. Tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Los Angeles. I'm Bob Cole with Don Cherry and Rick Callaghan of the Edmonton Oilers has joined us here in the third period for this game four at the Forum in Los Angeles, 3-1 Edmonton with 15:25 left in the third period. Again on the boards, and I'll tell you, the checking will be close now. The puck comes loose near the line, kept in by Jay Wells, finally to center. Anderson tried to go in. He was stopped by Larry Murphy. Wells backhands it up ahead. Taylor couldn't play it. Anderson again shoots it back in for Edmonton. They've hit the five-minute mark of the third period. And Los Angeles trying to fight back now. They're trailing 3-1. Here's Zimmer coming in. Zimmer gets in front. Nice save by Grant Fuhr. He looked pretty cool that time, hanging onto it.
You know, Brett, now there's a kid right there. Is that a cute little kid or what?
Who, Coco? The little one sucking its thumb? Very cute. It looks like it's in.
Listen,
like
I've seen more hit in the air in the. All right, here's, he just puts a little wee one on. He's got that one. There's no problem. That Fuhr could have hit pocket. More hitting in this game than all season. Brett, why?
I think because of the intensity of the game. You need that to play a smart game. And I just think that because of the intensity there, the series, the rivalry between our divisions, I think it's just the intensity and basically the guys just working together as a team.
From the draw, back to the line. Hardy gets set. Gets the shot. Fuhr covered up. Another shot. Fuhr stopped it. And he hangs on to it. And they do some pushing and shoving in front of Grant Fuhr. Semenko has not played in the hockey game. Now they're starting to throw punches. That was lovely. Through one. And Hardy comes after him. And away she goes.
That's okay. Everybody stand back now. Don't get misconducts. They're not going to throw it too many. They got a death grip on there. You're all right. Don't let it go. Everybody get back so you don't get misconducts. Gary LaRiviere, get back. See, there won't be any. Let them go. There won't be. There will not be any misconducts in this one, and that's good.
Lumley got the right hand loose. He took one right to the jaw. Now he gets the right hand loose himself. And I believe now the linesman will move in because we're up against that goal post. And I don't think anything will be through there. We're on the ropes.
Well, sometimes you have to let them go like that. That's the way you settle down. The rest of the guys will see, hey, wait, we're not going to step in.
Hardy and Lumley will get major penalties here at 14:38 of the third period. This is Hockey Night in Canada from the Forum in Los Angeles. Well, it all happened. Major penalties handed out in front of Grant Fuhr. When Fuhr made the big save, frustration set in, I believe.
Well, I think it's frustration, but also they're trying to do the same thing that they did the last game, and we lost our cool. But yet there, they both were assessed 2-minute minors plus 5-minute fighting penalty, so they're playing even strength. So that just shows the basic discipline we have. And no one else got involved, and no one else took any stupid penalty, so which is key on our part.
Right, and you know Ron Wicks handled it right. He went around, pushed all the guys back. Get away, you guys. Let them go. If they want to go, let them go. And he played it right. There was no misconduct like there was the last time.
Well, they got minors. And here's the announcement again.
2 minutes for roughing. Number 20, Dave Lumley, 5 minutes for fighting. Los Angeles penalties to number 17, John Paul Kelly, 2 minutes for high sticking. Number 20, Mark Hardy, 5 minutes for fighting.
Okay, Lumley and Hardy, major penalties, and Boschman and Kelly had the minors.
You know who Boschman's playing like now? Brett, I think you'll back me up on that. He's playing that aggressive, hard-driving game, blocking shots at the point like Hughes. And he reminds me of Hughes out there, taking the body. I think the two of them have got together.
Yeah, I think so, too. And also, I think that's the way Bosch, when he played in Toronto, when he first came there, that's the type of hockey he was playing. He's a great individual, great team man, and he's been a good asset to us.
Well, you know, when a guy puts his body down and blocks a shot, you know he wants to win, especially a forward, because there's not too many of them. Do you do it, Brett?
Once in a while.
Dion is at center ice for L.A. The Kings have outshot Edmonton 22-17 to this point of the game. They're nearing the six-minute mark of the third period. That's Siltanen. He tried to go in, was stopped, then went over the boards at the L.A. bench. And again, the play is called. Somewhere along in this third period, I'm not sure when, Don, you tell me. L.A. is going to have to open up. They're down 2 goals. They've got to wait for a chance, yes, but they're going to have to open up somewhere.
Well, what Glenn Sather's doing, he's not putting Gretzky out against Dion like he was earlier. He's playing this 3-1. He's checking Gretzky. He's checking Dion now.
Putty on the boards with it. Two Kings bumped together. Gretzky is there trying to find it, but here comes Dion. Dion had it slapped away by Curry, who got back. A good play up to center for Gretzky. Two Kings are back. Gretzky gave it away. Just left it for Dion. Into the corner, that's Wells. Can't get away from Curry. Now circling is Dion again. 3-1 Edmonton. Dion on the move. In with a shot. Low shot hit the outside of the post. And bounced away. Wells sent it over to the right wing. The King trying to get it organized. Bozak was slow coming out. Murphy had to wait. And now Dion, he's bumped there by Siltanen, and it goes to center Gretzky again. Lost control of it. And the Kings, Jay Wells, put it ahead for Nichols. But Murphy coming in. He stops. Bozak on the boards, cleared it into the corner. Los Angeles with some pressure on now. They're looking for a goal right here. Needed badly. Right in front of the net it comes. And it's stopped by the line by Lewis. He fell. Two Oilers break out. Curry got it ahead. Hunter going in. Shoot! It's stopped by Lessard. Nice low shot, but Lessard made the save.
I was talking to Parker McDonald on the way up the stairs. I said, Parker, what do you think, 3-1? He says, we got to give him another goal so we can get going. 3-1's not enough.
We don't want to give him that.
It's funny, goal. Excuse me. It's funny when it's 3-1 how you play different than if it was 4-1. When it's 3-1, you keep tight, but as soon as you get that fourth goal, you loosen up a little, right?
You have a tendency to do that. That's right.
I'll tell you, it happened in that first game when it was 4-1. Everybody loosened up. Ended up 10-8. But here, post-checking game tonight, 3-1. And Korab lobbed one out to center. Got a thigh injury, but he's on there, as you can see. Korab going in. Playing a whale of a game. It's Smith. What a save by Fuhr. Smith was set. Another chance in front. The Oilers having difficulty clearing it. Finally, they get it out over the line. And the Kings come awfully close. Penalized players step back on. 12:30 left in the third period. 3-1 Edmonton. Coming in. That's Perry. Rolled it to the side of the net. George stopped it. Oilers just hanging on now. Finally clear it outside the line into the center ice area. They hold it on the boards, and it's called. Brett, want to thank you very much for dropping in. Good luck in the rest of the series.
Thank
for your sake, maybe there's another game.
All right, thank you very much. Then it's a treat sitting beside my hero, Don Cherry.
All right, see you in Edmonton.
All right, thank you very much.
With a score, Edmonton 3, and Los Angeles 1. This is Stanley Cup 82. While 14 remaining in the third period, Oilers lead by 2 goals. And now they're moving it from center ice. Gregg fired it in. L.A. trying to bring it out at hop high, but stayed on the playing surface. Evans dropped it back. Coming out as well. Right wing pass. Bonner couldn't pick it up. And again, Edmonton just clearing it to the center ice area. Ralston played it in for Boschman. Into the side of the net. It's center! What a chance right there with Lessard going down to the puck up high over the crossbar. Now, this is Evans. Takes the shot, but get it away when he tried to. On the boards, the Oilers again cover. But Bonner digs it out. Bonner spinning around for L.A. Bonner trying to spring somebody loose. Gets it back near the line. Fjord knifes it away. There's Messier losing it. Another shot, but he scores! He scores! Here we go again. It's 3-2. This goal coming at 8:44.
Here it is. He just shovels it in. Fjord makes a nice save. We don't know whether it goes in from up here. Looks like they just misfired. Went between his legs. He never really got the full one on it. Now watch how he just misfires. Hits the guy's skate, goes over, he misfires, goes between his legs. All right, here's another angle. Notice it hits his skate. He didn't direct it. Keeps it in, misfires a little in the corner.
Mike Murphy is first of this series at 8:44. And that's a mighty big goal. It's 3-2. Edmonton, but L.A. is coming on the draw. Chartrand got it ahead. It's inside the line again, and Fogelin goes back. Fogelin along the boards, trying to move it out as Unger. Unger gets it down to center. That's Lowe playing it in over the line. Hunter coming up against Dion. Dion bump. Unger missed it. Lowe at the blue line, kept it on side. Fired it in, but now Simmer comes out. Here's Dion. Taylor catching up. Dion rolled it in front. Had it bounce in front, and he grabbed it. Hockey Night in Canada will continue in a moment. Bob Cole and Don Cherry. John Wells at the Forum in Los Angeles. It's 3-2 Oilers.
I hate to say this, I hate to say it, but they had 5 guys back. You can't play it that way.
Again, the Kings keep the pressure on Edmonton. Here's Bosek in the corner with Hockton. He stopped. On the other side, Murphy flipped it in to Hopkins behind the net. He centered it. And the Oilers leave it there, but Gretzky brings it out with Curry. A pass ahead to Curry. Doesn't work. Curry stopped at it. And the Kings break out of the zone. What a check on Smith. They continue on, though. Bozak gets in front. Can't get the shot. Hopkins went after it. A backhand shot by Murphy is wide. Again, Gretzky to center. Gretzky going up over the line. And offside is Anderson. And it's called. We got to point something out to you people across Canada now. Generally, we don't show you this end zone shot, but the fans here in the Forum are on their feet a lot. And of course, that takes away the view of our cameras up here on this shelf position. So you might be looking at this shot more often than you had before.
You know, I hate to say the old adage. In the old days, they used to say, when the score is right now, next goal wins the game. That's what Perry's telling the truth right now. Next goal wins the game.
Wells pass to the right side. It's all in L.A. now. They're really moving. Coming in is Kelly. Hughes bump. Olivier is back there trying to hang on to it. Olivier fighting along the boards. Hit the referee's stick, but he got it out down the ice. No icing. 9:34 left in regulation time. Edmonton 3, Los Angeles 2. It was 3-1 going into this period. And the Kings have got one goal. Olivier was back. Poked it ahead, offside is called against the Los Angeles Kings.
Well, LeRivier did what he was supposed to do. When he gets the puck near the blue line, just get it over the blue line.
Live from the Forum, the Stanley Cup playoffs. Here's Hunter going in for Edmonton. He was upended in front of the net. And the play had been whistled back on the offside anyway. 9:04 remaining in regulation time, 3-2 Oilers.
Here we are, King Korab's back. He takes a little thing. You're not going to, unless it's a murder, you're not going to get a penalty call now in a 3-2 game. There's no way he was going to call that. Korab's back. Now he comes back from that deep curly horse he had. He's got all summer to rest it if they can put out, so why not?
Simmer, Dion, and Taylor once again for Los Angeles. And Lewis and Korab, the two defensemen. Edmonton with Gary Unger and Hughes to the right side.
You've got to go at him, Bob. You've got to go at him. Don't lay back. Don't give this line. This is one of the, last year was one of the hottest scoring lines in hockey. You can't lay back. Go at him, go at him. He's got Unger out there now to check them. Check them, check them.
Hunter's on the left wing for Edmonton. Ready to go, Unger, I think.
Throwing him out in law. Not a lot now, Bob.
And Hughes comes in. Got the draw back to his defenseman. Mogulin. Lobbed it on the boards to center ice. The Kings have been carrying the play here in the third period. Korab fired one ahead to Simmer. Simmer left it. Dion scooped it to the far side. Hunter looks for it against Taylor. And a chance. Hunter going in with Hughes. Hunter! And he has the goal. Who's had to cut the angle. Hunter played it well, waited for Lessard to cover up with the man in front, but he didn't. And it goes to Dion, racing in. Dion back to the goal, whipping to the corner. Dion gets it to the line. Murphy going in. Here's Murphy. Scramble for it. Hunter is back there, and he cleared it on the boards, and the Oilers can't move it out. Dion again. He's bumped back there by Lowell. Hunter after it. Hunter fired it into the corner on the other side. Hard and push each other. Up the line. Simmer grabbed it. The whistle goes and we're going to get a pair of penalties, I believe. Murphy and Hunter. This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Los Angeles. Here at 11:56, Hunter and Murphy are gone for roughing. So they'll be five aside, and that may be a break for Edmonton with a little more room out there.
Well, I see Unger giving Ron Wicks heck. I've learned from experience, don't yell at Ron Wicks. You'll pay in the end if you do.
8 minutes now left in regulation time. They're a goal apart at this stage. Out coming in, Messier had it poked off his stick. Oilers have to get back on side quickly. Boschman left it for Messier. Messier going into the corner. Messier around the net. Overskates it and left the puck there. Coming out, the Kings led by Bernie Nichols. Nice. Boschman covered him. Nichols got it again. Played it over on this side. Smith tried to knock it toward the net. Smith again. Centered it. And it went by Charlie Huddy into the corner. Silton it for Edmonton. Fake once, twice, then lobbed it off the boards down inside the L.A. line. 7:15 remaining in regulation time. Oilers lead by a goal, 3-2. On the line now, Siltanen ahead to Huddy. Fake the shot, try to set up Gretzky. It was deflected back to center. Curry to Huddy, to Gretzky, too far. Lessard out of the net to give it to Bozek. Bozek pokes it to center ice. LeRivier couldn't stop him. Here's Gretzky on the move. Took a long shot. Right on, and Lessard, no problem with that one. 6:50 left in regulation time. The Kings organizing. Here they come, led by Wells. The pass goes in on the right side. He tried to tip it in over Fuhr, but it went off Fuhr and then over the net. Wells again from center. He's stopped by Gregg. The Kings pour it on once more. Korab getting in front with Bonner. On the boards, Bozak is covered. They'll get a whistle there. 6:20 remaining.
Well, from here on in, Bob, you'll see a lot of whistles. Nobody wants to give it away. They'll be freezing them. All right, he's going in. He puts it in front. He didn't quite have the handle on it. He couldn't. Fuhr comes out and tips it by him. Fuhr had it all the way. Here's another angle on now. He lays it in front. He just lays it in front, but Fuhr sees it coming. The guy couldn't get a hold of it. Curry back checking there.
What do you think Saylor is telling his boys down there now, he and Billy Harris?
Well, what he did was, you can see it by Gretzky, because what happened, Gretzky normally would hang on to that puck and go in the corner and maybe get caught. He let it go at the blue line and picked up his wing.
Unger into the faceoff spot again for Edmonton. Bonner is there with him, and Bonner is waved out. So Evans will come in. Unger remains. 6:20 remaining. Unger got the draw. Once again, Edmonton now lining up. They haven't had much offensive drive in this third period. It's been all L.A. It was 3-1, now it's 3-2. So the Oilers hang on to that one-goal lead. Penalized players get ready to step back on. Now they're on. They're at full strength. And the Kings come again. This is Bonner bringing it in. Skated around a couple of players. Went into the corner with it. Fogelin got back to lob it up on the boards. Kept in. Kelly into the corner. Got it back near the line. Again, Fogelin. He'll clear it this time. That's all, though. Barely outside the line. Here's Evans breaking in. Offside is called at the blue line.
What happened there on the offside? He got pushed in. Unger pushed him in offside. It's actually an interference call, but it's never called. It's a smart move.
So with 5:39 remaining in regulation time, we're not going to mention overtime yet, of course, but these two teams, Don, have been awfully close right from the start of this series, and it was supposed to have been an Oilers series.
All the way. Everything was supposed to be. Everybody was talking about three straight.
They drop it in. Rolled over the line. Siltanen cleared it over on the far side. Huddy got it out. L.A. in possession again. Pass went off Huddy's stick. Here come the Kings. In front is Kelly. Didn't get the pass. Into the corner. Huddy fell on it. And 5:20 remaining now.
Well, what do you see, Bob? Like I said earlier, there's going to be a lot of whistles from here on in. Nobody's going to throw it blind. Nobody's going to throw it up the middle.
Don, it appears to me as if Edmonton is satisfied with that one-goal lead, but my goodness, well, 5:20 remaining.
You know, what happens is everybody comes up with that wise saying, they sat on a 3-2 lead. You don't mean to sit on a 3-2 lead, but it just happens.
Huddy played it off the boards. It's cleared again. Oilers get it out as far as the line, and that's it. Now they bring it out. Coming down on the plate, Curry nearly got away from everyone. Gretzky is up on the play also. Anderson takes it to the far side, away from Murphy. Anderson is back at the net, is bumped by Murphy. The side out of the goal. Kelly trying to come up with it. Puck is loose there. Now Nichols goes in. They'll get a whistle. There it is. And 4:50 remaining in regulation time. The Edmonton Oilers fell behind L.A. 1-0. In the first period, as Dion scored, Curry tied it at 10-18. And then in the second, it was Hughes and Anderson. And it looked pretty comfortable going into this third period. But Murphy has scored at 8:44, and it's now 3-2.
Grinding it out here. This is where the grinders. Here comes the grinders.
Now it's a chance right in front of the net. To the corner. Bozak goes in to help. Gets his stick on it. Can't clear it out, though. And at the far side, Hopkins brings it out. Oilers break it up near center. 4.5 minutes remaining as Wells takes it. Well, starting out, Raposa. He stopped their center. Siltanen brings it in. That's Curry on the left. Siltanen gets in front, can't shoot it. Wells to play. The close-up didn't work. Gretzky back near center right. Toss the pass ahead on the left wing. And Smith comes back. Orr's hand up. Smith leading this attack. Orr is backing up on the play. So it goes into the zone easily. Low is back there. Knocks it away to Unger. Unger takes his time. Unger played it up on the left side. Here's center ice. It's grabbed by the Kings and Hardy starts away again. 3:50 remaining in regulation time. Fogelin shoots it in. 3-2 Edmonton. Harry Murphy back of the net. King circle. That's Smith to the right. Murphy comes this way. Now to Smith. He missed it. Unger from center. Shoots it in. Got stopped at the blue line. And now the Kings backing up with 3.5 minutes left in regulation time. Hardy's play ahead. Comes to Simmer. Hughes slapped at it. He's pushed away by Hardy, and Murphy goes back. Dion is on the ice again. And there he goes. The play to Simmer. Dion to the right wing was offside. The play is called with 3:14 remaining in regulation time. The Edmonton Oilers 3 and the Los Angeles Kings 2. A win tonight for the Kings. They'll advance against Vancouver. A win tonight for Edmonton. Of course, the fifth game tomorrow night in Edmonton.
Well, it looks like L.A., what they're trying, it's like a knockout punch. They're not trying to grind it up, come up slowly. They're trying for that one big pass to spring Dion or spring somebody. They should come up like an army. Get in there, get a face off in that end.
Dion got the draw. Big Korab fired it in on the board. Back of the net, Kevin Lowe trying to clear it. Stopped on his first attempt. Now he's bumped hard. But the Oilers, three of them, stayed out with it. That's Boschman going in. Boschman! But the low weak shot, then couldn't reach the rebound. And Korab gets it over on this left wing for Simmer. He had some difficulty. Fired it ahead. It's knocked down. In front is Dion. Rolled it to the far side of Taylor. And he was spun around and fell. That nearly clicked in front for Taylor. Dion had a great chance.
What they're complaining about, Korab's over at Ron Wick. He pulled it into his body. But Ron's not going to call something like that in a 3-2 game with 2 minutes to go.
Precisely 2:42 remaining in regulation time as you see Dion coming in.
Watch, he puts it back, just can't find the handle. It's over in the corner. Coming pretty close, though, coming pretty close. Now watch the defenseman fall on it, but he's not going to call it now.
Edmonton 3, Los Angeles 2, fourth game of this best-of-five series. And a whale of a series it is. Gretzky comes back on for Edmonton. Curry will be on with him, of course, and Anderson.
Well, what Glenn Sather's doing, slowing things down a little, changing lines, having guys talk to the referee, slow everything down. Just don't jump into it.
Nichols, Fox, and Kelly against the Gretzky line. There's the draw. Nichols in the corner. Along the boards, Fox fell. And it's hooked on the boards down the ice. It goes over the red goal line. Hardy was racing back. He catches it ahead of Curry, and it's icing again against Edmonton.
Well, a lot of people are sitting home now, and a lot of coaches saying, why do you ice that puck? Why do you do that? If you're going to put it out, and you know you're going to ice it, put it down. Just don't float it out there. Be decisive about the thing. Don't say, well, I'm going to put it half out, because you know what happens when you put it half out.
2:28 remaining in regulation time.
See how slow he's coming back to the faceoff. Slow everything down. Let everything go. Curry's just wandering back there. Slow everything down. Don't get excited.
Edmonton hanging on to a one-goal lead. And they're 2:28 away from forcing a fifth game of the series. Now Gretzky racing out. Gretzky, a good move to the left side against Korab. He popped him on the boards. And the Kings, Kelly, from his own zone. Pass ahead, stop near center. Siltanen and Huddy shoot it in. Offside call. 2:08 remaining in regulation time.
I think when he's getting a goalie, I think what he'd do is he'd like to face off in that end. I always liked about a minute and 30 to go, in between a minute and 30 and a minute all the time. But you like a face off in that end.
We'll be keeping an eye on the goaltender, Mario Lessard, down at the far side. There he is. Now they drop it in, and away we go. Coming up to 2 minutes remaining in the period. 3-2. Edmonton and the LA Kings on the move. They clear it over the line. It's fired back out. 1:50 remaining in regulation time. Well, again, stopped by Gretzky. He just flipped it in. He doesn't want to carry it anywhere. 1:40 remaining in regulation time. Three Kings on the move to center ice. Bozek is going in. On this left side is Hopkins. Hopkins trying to center it. Hopkins gets it back in the line. A shot by Wall. Knocked down in front by Fuhr. Now it's centered. Comes near the line. Wells keeping it in. Great pressure on now by L.A. But Gretzky has it. 1:20 left to play in regulation time. Gretzky coming in. Gretzky lost control of it. 1 minute and 10 seconds remaining. The Kings now get it as far as center. And the Oilers dump it back in. Lessard climbs desperately to get out of the net. Under his inch forecheck, a good play by Hunter. He's held on the boards by Wells, and that will force a faceoff in the Los Angeles zone with exactly 1 minute remaining. A good play by Unger, Don.
Well, I'll tell you, he's been aggressive. He's skating now like he was 19 years old. He's in there. That's a big faceoff in that end, I'll tell you.
A faceoff to the left of Lessard. Korab went after it. Now he starts. The play comes to the line. Bozek shoots it to center. Here comes Lessard out of the net. They have the extra man on. Vogelin finding it. Unger gets it on the board. A soft play comes out to the line. Vogelin racing up, shoots it down the ice. There'll be no wasting with 40 seconds left now. Korab back of the net. Bozek played it on the boards to Fox. 30 seconds left. Oilers trying to hang on. Unger slapped at it. It bounces it over the line, and Hughes has a chance. But he was grabbed by Korab, couldn't move. 22 seconds left. And the Oilers are point-checking now. Hughes upended. That allows Bozek to get moving. Down across center. Nichols is bumped up the line by Fogelin. 10 seconds left. The Oilers are hanging on, folks. They've got it done. 5 seconds left. Here's a chance. No. At the side of the net. And it's over. The Edmonton Oilers, with great discipline, courage, they hung on and stayed off the Los Angeles comeback Kings.
Well, let me tell you something. That took a lot of heart. Look at Glenn Sather and them out there. Took a lot of heart to lose the game 5-0. Get compose yourself. I think that day off really helped them cut together. And they, a lot of discipline. The discipline they didn't have before, they showed tonight. And that's what got them in first place. They showed it. They're a young club. Look out in Edmonton.
So 3-1 going into this third period. Murphy made it close, 3-2 at 8:44, and that's all she wrote. Final score, Edmonton Oilers 3, the Los Angeles Kings 2. Don, what do we look for now back up in Edmonton?
Well, I'll tell you, they'll get that crowd behind them. They'll be going. Don't think they won't when they go on the ice. They'll be really flying. They'll be up. They won't let down. You'll